That is it. Yes, good morning students. So today your topic is microorganisms, our friends and foe. According to the content, according to the topic, here in this topic we will see about the useful microorganisms as well as harmful microorganisms. So before starting the chapter, I would like to tell you about the microorganisms. So students, all we are living in the world of microorganisms, but the thing is that the size of the microorganism is so small that we can't see with our naked eyes, but their presence can be felt because of their band effects, means they cause disease. That's why only we can feel their presence in our world. So with the definition I would like to start. What are microorganisms? So students, micro means very small, means tiny. So those organisms which are so small that we cannot see with our naked eye, means वो इतने सूक्ष्म होते हैं, इतने छोटे होते हैं कि इनको हम हमारी खाली आंखों से नहीं देख सकते हैं. For that we need a microscope, and that in some cases we need special type of microscope, you can say like that electronic microscope. So students, to see these microorganisms we need a special kind of instrument, that is electron microscope. See students, when that microscope was not invented, before that our world, they were quite blind, they were not familiar about the presence of microorganisms. It means we didn't have any idea about the microorganisms. Some disease that time also were there, but actually we considered that these diseases are due to the curse of God. As soon as the science, due to the technology, due to the advancement in the science, we got new idea, and it was the discovery of microscope. When microscope came in our hand, after that all the thing became clear, and we came to know about the presence of microorganisms in our surroundings. So now students, question comes that where these are found, where these microorganisms found in the world. So students, I want to say there is no any place that is free from microorganisms. I am telling, if you see in food, every food may contain or microorganisms such as bacteria. After that, microorganism is present in our air in which we breathe. After that, they are found in soil, in water, on our body, even inside our body also. It means students, there is no place where microorganisms presence is not there. It means we are not totally free from microorganisms. So students, this topic is very interesting topic. So now I would like to classify the microorganism students. So students, microorganisms word is classified in five major categories. Five major groups are there. I have marked here, first group is bacteria, second is virus, Third is protozoa. Fourth is algae. And fifth is fungi. Once again, I am repeating, students, this whole microorganism is classified in five major groups. How many major groups, students? Five major groups. They are first bacteria, second virus, third protozoa, fourth algae, and fifth fungi. So these are the major group of microorganism. So students, one by one we will see about them. One by one we will study about that particular microorganism. So students, I start with the bacteria. Bacteria, students, bacteria name you know, everyone know that what are the bacteria. Actually, bacteria are microorganisms. They are so small that we can't see with our naked eye. For example, daily, every day, you eat curd. You eat curd. Dahi. You see, if you see the curd, if you put one drop of curd under the microscope, you will be surprised to see that millions of lactobacillus bacteria are present. So by seeing, you can surprise. It means, and one more example about the bacteria, if you see one drop of pus, you know pus, pus means mava, which comes from a wound, a ghouse, a boom, one drop single, pus oozes, which bahar nikalti hai. If that one drop of pus, if you put under the microscope, you will find the total number of bacteria 10 raised to power 8 means approximate 10 crore. It means one single drop of pus contains 10 crore bacteria, students. How many bacteria? 10 crore. So many other things are there. So now, just we will see there. First of all, there are single cell. All the bacteria contain only one cell in their body. That's why they are known as single cell organism. And one more interesting thing, they have both the cell wall. They contain a cell wall. Like the plant cell wall is there, they also contain cell wall. And one more thing, they don't have a well-defined nucleus. They don't have any well-defined, well-organized nucleus. It means nucleus is lacking. Nucleus is lacking in the bacteria, students. And now I would like to tell about the occurrence, where they are found. Earlier I discussed that all the microorganisms, like the other microorganisms, bacteria are also found everywhere. I have told you that bacteria are found in soil, in water, in air, in food, on our body, even inside our body also. It means there is no any space which is free from bacteria. Now, students, size. You are very eager to know about the size, how much they are big. Students, you will be surprised to know that the size of the bacteria varies from 0.2 micron. How much, students? 0.2 micron to 100 micron. How much? Between 0.2 micron to 100 micron. The smallest size of the bacteria is 0.2 micron. and largest size of the bacteria is 100 micron. Now students, you don't know what is the micron. Actually 1 micron is equal to 10 raised to power minus 3 mm. 10 raised to power minus 3 mm. Mm is millimeter. It means the size of the bacteria is a thousandth part of 1 millimeter. If you see the size of the bacteria, you will find the size of the bacteria is 1000th part of millimeter, 1 millimeter. It means if you divide 1 millimeter length by 1000, how much portion will come in your hand? That is 1 micron. So students, size of the micron varies from 0.2 micron to 100 microns. And now students, next coming to ask the type of bacteria. Bacteria also classified in four categories. Four types of bacteria detected. We have found four types of bacteria, students, which I am telling. First is spherical bacteria, students. Second is rod shaped bacteria. Third is spiral bacteria. Fourth is coma shaped bacteria. So students, these are the types of bacteria. Once again revising, spherical type bacteria, it means their structure is like the sphere, like the shape are there. For example, cocci. Cocci is the example of spherical bacteria. You learn only one example because you are in 8th standard. No need to learn more and more examples. So spherical bacteria example is cocci. Cocci is the example of what kind of bacteria, student? Spherical bacteria. And now next, rod shaped bacteria. What is this rod? Rod shaped bacteria, students, like this. This is like the rod. Rod means chard. And the example is bacilli. Bacilli bacteria, bacilli bacterium is the example of rod shaped bacteria. Actually, bacteria and bacterium. Sometimes I am using bacteria word, sometimes I am using bacteria word. Why? If one bacteria, that is the bacterium, and if more than one, this plural form of bacterium is bacteria. If I am using bacteria, it means I am talking about a group of bacteria, many bacteria. If I am using bacteria word, it means I am talking about the only single bacterium. Correct, friends? And now third is spiral bacteria. Spiral type of bacteria, they are just like the spiral. You have seen that your notebook, you have seen that your register, that's your word spiral. So these type of bacteria, spiral bacteria, students, you can see they are in this shape. An example for the spiral bacteria is Spirilla. What's meant? Spirilla. Spirilla is the example of spiral bacteria. I have drawn this diagram of this spiral. This is the rod shaped bacteria and this is the spherical bacteria. So students, now last and final, that is coma shaped bacteria. Coma shaped, students, like this. These are very small, like the coma. In the question, in the sentence, you put coma. So like the coma, some bacteria look like the coma. So you can say the example of coma shaped bacteria is Vibrio. So students, Vibrio bacteria is the example of coma shaped bacteria. So once again I am revising, students. Here I have told there are four types of bacteria we have discovered. So I told that spherical, rod shaped, spiral and coma. Example of each and every one I have told you here. So students, spirochetal bacteria, example is cocci. Second, rod-shaped bacteria, example is bacilli. And spiral-shaped bacteria, example is spirilla. And last, finally, coma-shaped bacteria, example is coma-shaped vibrio. Coma-shaped bacteria, example is vibrio. So we have discussed about the type of bacteria. Now one more thing left, students. Nutrition. Nutrition means the process of taking food. What do they eat? How do they eat? It means we are going to discuss about the nutrition in bacteria. Students, you know, bacteria don't contain any kind of chlorophyll in it. It means they are not capable to produce their own food. It means they are heterotrophic type. They are heterotrophs. Why? Because they don't contain any chlorophyll. It means they are not able to produce, they are not able to make their own food, students. So here, however, some certain bacteria are there, they produce their own food also. You surprised to learn, to know about this. Although 99% almost bacteria, they are saprophytic, means they are heterotrophic, and either they derive their food from the dead or decaying material, from the dead or decaying organism, or some bacteria live in the symbiotic relationship, students. Symbiotic relationship. I have earlier told that symbiotic relationship, example is rhizobium bacteria. I told that rhizobium bacteria, they dwell, they abode, they live, they stay. Where? In the root nodules of leguminous plants, such as gram, pea. So in the root nodules of these plants, they abode, they stay, they make their home, they take the shelter there only. So students, I have told that almost bacteria, they have to depend from other organisms. Other organisms here, either that are decaying materials or they live in symbiotic relationship. But students, one more thing I am telling. However, some bacteria, only certain bacteria, they make their own food also. And they are categorized, they are classified in two categories. One student, Chemotropus, and one is the Chemotropus and other is the Phototropus. Chemotropus and Phototropus, here two words are there, students. So chemo means chemical. It means certain bacteria, they obtain the energy from where? From the chemical which is obtained by the breakdown of inorganic materials. So first they break down the inorganic material, and whatever the energy is obtained, whatever the energy is derived from there, they survive, friends. So this type of bacteria is known as chemotrophs. And next is, I have told you about the second type, that is the phototrophs. Some certain bacteria, they obtain their energy from sunlight. So by obtaining the energy from the sunlight, they survive, students. So here I have discussed two autotrophic types of bacteria. Correct, students? So today this is enough, and tomorrow we will continue with the virus, students. So up to here, everyone will listen, and you can share the things, the views with me. I hope that everyone today understood. Thank you. Have a nice day.